Hi, I'm Irina Rish. I'm an associate professor at the University of Montreal, Computer Science and Operations Research Department. And I'm also a core member of Mila, Quebec AI Institute.
So one of the sectors that AI has potentially the most potential to add value to, and of course it's not the only one, but is health. And I often hear in interviews people say in Canada, we have a lot of data, we have a very large, very extensive formal health system, and so we have a lot of data, but you know, doing something about that data requires you know, machine learning and those kinds of technologies. How well positioned is Montreal specifically in the AI for health field, let's say?
Yeah, this is indeed a very good point you just made about the kind of wealth of data that are constantly created, not just in Canada, I mean, I would say in many other countries. And the challenge is that bringing healthcare up to speed with technology is one of the largest problems, I would say, among, well, kind of practical applications of artificial intelligence. And specifically in Montreal, we have, I mean, I think it's a unique combination of talent and know-how and established organizations around universities like McGill and the University of Montreal and CSU, Saint-Justine, and so on and so forth. I mean, there is lots of expertise here in healthcare, in medicine and neuroscience specifically. That's a field I'm quite interested in and working on the intersection of AI and neuroscience. So there is lots of expertise in biology, neuroscience, healthcare, variety of other kind of aspects of medicine. At the same time, and especially recently, there is lots of expertise in artificial intelligence and computing. And synergy of those two is quite unique. And that makes, I think, Montreal a very attractive place for companies who would like to work at the intersection of AI and healthcare. Yeah, so I would say talent, know-how, also the fact that Montreal is like a top university city. It was ranked even like above Vancouver and even Toronto and New York. So it's kind of like the best university city of the world. It's like largest number of students, like post-secondary and so on. So this is really unique. It's almost like a Silicon Valley, I would say, of Canada. So just like Stanford and the University at Berkeley kind of produced talent and brains to fuel Silicon Valley economy, I think that's what's happening in Montreal now.
So if we talk about health today, of course, the first thing that comes to mind is the pandemic. And one of the things that I found the most amazing is how fast the vaccine and multiple vaccines, in fact, have been developed in just over a half a year or so. And I think that's a world record. What are some of the applications of AI that you are the most excited about? And is that one of them, by the way?
We had multiple discussions with my colleagues and started several projects within the under the umbrella of so-called COVID task force. Essentially, it started from various conversations with my colleagues in math and biology, like Guy Wolf, for example. And we were wondering if we can do something about data analysis to determine most critical factors, whether genetic or related to kind of particular person health state and so on and so forth. It was totally open question. What determines the disease progression trajectory? Because there is so much variance there. Basically, many people at Mila, including, of course, Yoshio Benjo, immediately joined the task force that we initiated with Guy and also Joel Pinot and in vivo folks, the startup that's co-located with Mila and many, many others started working on different projects where we try to see how AI can possibly help with different aspects of pandemics. With Yoshio Benjo and his team, we worked on the AI-based contact tracing. The idea with Yoshio Benjo and his team was to do much more efficient and faster notifications by taking clues from the data, not only whom the person met, but whom those contacts met. So basically propagating the information and doing risk assessment. So using like probabilistic inference to do assessment of the risk that you actually were exposed and likely to develop disease. Doing that probabilistically using inference techniques from machine learning was supposed to provide the extra speed up in terms of notification and also give you some way of judging the confidence of this kind of inference.
Yeah, absolutely. I think you could call it a hot topic. And I was just going to ask you about talent and basically people. Obviously AI and the tech sector in general are very competitive and globally competitive. And that means that people are sometimes fighting for access to talent. How much talent is there in the AI space in Montreal? And what is being done to continue to train and attract and retain top AI talent in Montreal, especially considering the challenge right now of getting students to physically come to Montreal?
I think CIPAR program is amazing in terms of providing incentives for people to join universities in Montreal and Mila. And as you know, I mean, the CIPAR program was announced in 2017, and there was, I think, $175 billion. But I mean, it's a huge investment by Canadian government. And I think it creates a positive feedback loop or like virtuous cycle. The significant investments from the government towards fundamental research, helping to attract people, both like professors and students and so on. And there are many other grants available that professors can apply for. So this is really kind of unique to Canada. So I think the government investment, but also companies, I mean, Montreal is now the home to many AI research labs, Microsoft and DeepMind and Facebook AI research, and even like virtual lab between IBM Research and Mila. I'm coming from IBM Research, and kind of part of my mission was also to make sure that we establish tighter collaborations. So all these companies are both supporting fundamental research with grants and providing resources.
Can you think of recent investments specifically in the AI for health sector, let's say, in Montreal, foreign investments that you would highlight?
Well, I guess, it was all over in the news, back in October. Novartis opened a lab in collaboration with Mila, and there are multiple other companies before, but this is, I guess, most recent example. And the rationale behind that was similar to, I guess, what was previously mentioned by other companies. They would like to be collaborating with top minds in AI and also top minds in healthcare, biology, medicine. So in this sense, Montreal is kind of very attractive place, and being co-located with Mila. I understand right now it's pandemics and so on, but essentially there are many startups. Many of them are medical or biology related in general that are essentially next to Mila in pretty much the same building. And I guess Novartis new lab pretty much followed that hot trend. And that's nice to see that more and more healthcare companies are choosing Montreal and Mila in particular as close collaborators.
How embedded is Montreal in the global AI community, would you say?
Montreal, and especially recently with everything being virtual, is very connected, not just with universities and research labs around the world, but also with companies. There are very close collaborations between Mila and European AI organizations. And one example is Max Planck Institute, Bernard Schoenkopf's group, and very hot kind of topic work on discovering causal variables. Also very important topic also for healthcare applications, trying to build models that are robust to changes in the data, to out of distribution generalization. This is hot topic, which seemed to be really core to pushing AI to next level. And it's also very important for any kind of healthcare and medical applications. And collaborations along those lines go on with, as I mentioned, in Europe and multiple universities and research groups in the US and Berkeley, Stanford, MIT. We're also collaborating with IBM Research, as I mentioned, and clearly with Facebook AI Research and DeepMind and so on, not just the labs located in Montreal, but also kind of their counterparts in different countries. So I think Mila is really virtually connected to the rest of the world really well, academic world, but also, as I said, industrial. Again, thanks to your show and the reputation created over the past decade with advance of deep learning. So I would say it's truly international, and we have collaboration not just with European or Northern American companies, but for example, we have quite a bit of support from the Korean Research Institute, ETRI. We just had a conversation last evening with Yoshua and with our colleague from there, because it's ongoing collaboration with Mila and them. So it's pretty much connections with labs or companies and universities across the world, truly internationally, I would say.
How do you see the Montreal AI ecosystem evolve in the coming years? Do you see more foreign investment coming into it, or do you just, you know, see a lot of uncertainty?
I think that we are adapting even to pandemics, even to this online existence. And I guess it's well known that adaptation is pretty much the core property of any intelligent system. And I would say that AI ecosystem in Montreal is quite intelligent, so we're adapting. And I don't think, actually, in some sense, it's even better in terms of connectivity with other labs and people across the world, because now all the conferences are online anyway, and you don't really have to kind of travel there. As you said, in terms of predicting future, I only see for now quite steep upward trend. I might be overly optimistic, but something tells me that this optimism is well-founded.